Many a times, despite our best intentions, communication goes wrong. Why does this happen? Do companies suddenly forget why brands love them? Not really. Research suggests that this happens because each individual responds as per their personalized view of the world. Let me put it this way. One man's terrorist is another man's freedom fighter. The likelihood that two people will react to the same communication in the same way is not 100%. At the turn of the century, a cigarette maker commissioned a study in the Czech Republic about the effects of smoking. It turned out that the deaths due to smoking were recommended to be a good thing, as it helped the government prioritize funds to those who needed them the most. Millions were outraged by this suggestion, but turns out that many people agreed. Such examples on variance in responses abound. Over the last 10 years, I have shown the picture of a red dot to more than 4,700 people across the world and collected over 65 responses. My attempt was to document the variance in responses to something as simple as a red dot, an inanimate visual stimulus. The responses in India were as follows. Some people thought it was a bindi, some people thought it was a cricket ball. Folks from the Middle East interpreted the red dot to be evil or death or anger. Folks from Southeast Asia thought that the red dot represented Russia, communism, China, marriage, etc. The same image produced over 65 different responses, and I'm still tabulating. Each response was a function of the individual's unique experience. Political leaders most certainly understand this. They customize their speeches to suit the region. For instance, in a vast country like India, a speech in Uttar Pradesh would be very different from a speech given in Tamil Nadu. Business leaders also understand the importance of customizing their advertising communication according to the region it is intended for. Perhaps teachers know this best. Kids learn what you teach them right from childhood. The biases introduced in childhood can remain lifelong. I sent my red dot experiment to leading academics and practitioners across the world for their views. I am really happy that the Universal Business School has agreed to publish the same. I look forward to knowing what the red dot means to you. Please write to me. I hope this study sparks a thought in your mind too.